Welcome back, everybody, here to your coverage of the Join Dota Open. Big thanks to AMD for putting up $1,000 USD. The winner takes all prize money. That's the way this sucker works. And we get to see who will actually be the victor of this Open. Of course, the Open and the Masters go hand in hand. And a big shout out to all those people out there who will be competing in the competitions. If you've missed all the details, head yourself over to joindota.com and you'll find out all the details. You just ask in the chat, how do I win? Where is the free monies? And you'll find out. All right, only no Tidehunter. Only Tidehunter. Gotta take out that N from that one. OTH, also known as a sub name, once the Horde or something like that. Yeah, they're playing around with that because obviously their nickname makes a joke at no Tidehunter, who just got recently called the Alliance. So Cinderin and co. will be going up against Kaipi. Of course, it's a little bit of an interesting situation seeing Eternal Envy in Kaipi facing up against a team which has Tidehunter written in the name because it was actually his old squad before it went all Swedish. You know, without further ado, let's jump ourselves inside the game. You'll notice right now there's only four people in the roster for OTH. The fifth player is on his way home right now. That is Smugglik, who is currently missing. He will be joining the team in a couple of moments' time. But we're going to do our draft first so we get things underway. And yeah, we get ourselves started off. Now, KP up against OTH. As far as this round goes, if you want to also see the details for that one, again, would you believe everything's on the JoinDOTA website? Just go to the Thomas tab, click on the open thing, and you'll see what's happening in the grid right now. So this is what's happening in the grid. HWA and WinRAR are still playing. I believe that game is actually coming to a close right now, and the result will be entered shortly. IC Cup are waiting for their opponent. 4FC up against Pain. The QPAD Red Pandas have lost to the Romanians, so TO will face up against Arctic, and KB up against OTH. This is actually probably one of the best matches that we can get from this round. We'll jump ourselves down to probably 4FC versus IC Cup as our next one, as if we're assuming who's going to advance through. But HWO have been playing really well, and you should never ever count out a Brazilian team. Like, ever. Should never count them out. So yeah, should be some really cool rounds though coming up. We will complete all our games tonight. No matter what happens, we complete all our games tonight. Doesn't matter the fact that I'm catching a plane at like 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. Does not matter. We play. We play until the end. We play until the end. Yeah, let's back into the draft. Nature's Prophet, Queen of Pain, Shadow Demon coming off here from OTH. So again, we get a little bit of burst damage. We get some nice control, just in case the Kaipi are thinking about going for the PL. They've already got the Keeper of the Light as well as the Bane. First pick, of course, did go to only Tidehunter. So they took the Nature's Prophet as the first pick. So even with the Keeper of the Light in the field, everything else they kind of wanted was banned out. Wisp and Batrider, no one will ever let them have that. No one will let anybody ever have that. And then the mag as well as Nick's being taken out. And Puck, the third pick up here from Zizu. And I kind of like this. I kind of like this because this forces that. It forces the PL ban. It forces the PL ban. And because of that now, Sinner's like, well, okay, maybe. And this might even just be a bit of a bait. The offlaner is now so much more open right now. Nakes hasn't been selected either. So here's an option for both these squads. I say both these squads because with the Nature's Prophet and the Queen of Pain, Nakes have already got two great heroes to piggyback with. Puck for KP, they'll have that combination there, and Eternal Envy will be happy just to take a farming style hero. But one thing the problem will be for only... It's more of a problem for only Tidehunter. Remaining. They don't have stuns. If they pick up the Nakes, they're missing out some serious, serious stuns. They need a Lashrak and they need a Lina, or one of those two, to come their way to couple up right now with the SD. And Lashrak will be the more obvious pickup. I'm pretty sure Zizu will see this one and ban it out. Because with the Lashrak pickup, then they've got the possibility of combining it with the Nature's Prophet and pushing down towers very early on. That's what we're looking at here. And Lina is the first ban, and Void very quickly banned out by Cinderin. And there goes your Lashrak. So both the combos are taken out. Kaipi realize the problem. They realize the problem of only Tidehunter here. They're missing a large amount of stuns. This almost forced them to go as well into a Jakiro as the secondary support for OTH. Either that, or they say, screw it, we'll grab an Enchantress or a Chen, or possibly an Enigma. That way they'll actually have at least a guaranteed stun because of the Malifus, and just push down these towers very early on. Problem for the Enigma, though, he'll probably never get an ultimate off. And I say that because you can have Bane that's going to be causing him issues with either Nightmare or with the grip. And then you got Puck with Dream Coil. Decent range in that little sucker. Remaining. So easy to do. Easy to do. Remaining. Sindarin, fifth and final ban now. Fifth and final ban. One last high carry. I wouldn't be surprised if it's just an anti-mage. But there's still... Well, what else? What else would Eternal Envy like to take? They haven't got any kind of push just yet. I haven't seen Eternal Envy take up any kind of role like a lone druid. Might just force a different style of carry hero out from him. Of course, we saw the DK from Syndra in the last game. Might be a selection for this game too. Chill Breath with a catcher with a stun. Not a bad way of coupling up. And then they just need an extra stunner as their supporter. That's what they're searching for. But they also want to ban one out without crippling their crippling themselves. I wonder if KP also go for the whole hog. If they ban out... I guess they take out the Darkseer. So they ban at least one long lane hero here for Kaipi. I'm really, really interested to see what's going to happen. There's no one's taking the Nakes. They let the Nakes through. So ban out the Darkseer. But Nakes are still available. And that could be the first pick up here by Syndarin. But it's a dangerous pick to go. Because it's very minimal on the stuns. Disruption is the only real big interference thing. And they've already had the two like normal compilation ones, as I said, taken out. So, yeah. I'm interested.
10 seconds remaining.
So, fifth ban.
5 seconds remaining.
They take out the Chim.
Radiant team.
I think Zizu was also thinking the same thing as I was. It's getting really a bit scary right now that most of the time my logic starts to reflect out of the captains of these teams. But with the Chen now being banned out, so they are worried about a little bit of early aggressive push. The Enchantress, though, will still do the job. The problem with the Enchantress is if we go late game, the Enchantress really starts to tail off a lot more. That's the bigger problem. But in the early stages of the game, with the Nature's Prophet, it will pull Nature's Prophet off the top lane. So I'm really looking to see from Kaipi here where they go with a tower pushing hero. I wouldn't even be surprised right now if they want to go aggressive tri lane. Pick up a lone druid, let him run on the safe lane. And then run an aggressive tri lane down here on the bottom. If you're missing a large amount of stuns and you've got a Keeper of Light and a Bane down here, and you pick up something which is also rather aggressive. See, yeah, that's a Jakira pickup. So it was a trade-off. It was a trade-off. They had to go with. They got SD Jakira. Not a bad combination style. But up against the Keeper of the Light as well as a Bane, I would still pick Keeper of the Light and Bane as far as like the stronger supports. For all the control they give. And if Kaipi go even just one style of like more aggressive style hero that's a bit more tankier, it could be the DK themselves. Remaining. CK is still available in the pool as well, even though he's not going to be coupling up with a Wisp. He's still a very powerful hero. And they might just want to keep it secret.
Reserve time.
Keep them guessing on their lanes. The lone druid bear can still be picked up, and you think it could be either lane. And they go with a Nake. They don't even okay.
Radiant team.
So Nake selection. Who gives a crap about Jakiro's Ice Path when you have Rage? This does really have aggressive tri lane written all over it. But then again, it's not something the Kaipi always do. They can be a lot more defensive. They can stack with the Keeper of the Light. They can farm with the Keeper of the Light. Bane will just pull and keep whoever's on the top lane and all a nightmare or whatever is going on there.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds.
So the final
remaining.
Pickup from Syndarin. Who's going to be their number one carry slot?
Reserve time.
He wants someone that can really work well with the Shadow Demon and Jakiro. I'm wondering too if we even see something a little bit more different. Because we haven't seen heroes like Timbersaw or something like that. You still want someone that's going to be able to bring down Nakes.
10 seconds.
And if he was looking to go like a safe lane lone druid, it's not going to work. So they go Alchemist. So we get a little bit of farm. We get an extra stun as well. Nice synergy with the SD. So that stun, those extra stuns we were searching for come in the last two. Which means Kaipi, last selection. Offlane style hero, someone that will go up against Nature's Prophet more than likely. I say that because even with this Alchemist Jakiro SD, obviously that tri lane's actually very good now. That tri lane with the Alchemist really does a hell of a lot more. I would still, however, favor the Nakes, the Coddle, and the Bane. Only just though.
Reserve time.
It would really depend if they stop the rest of it, and they go on. Ah, how I love Kaipi. Why do I keep choosing these guys' games to cast? It makes no sense. Yeah, so we'll have a very, very quick remake. A very, very quick remake. With that last selection, though, it does mean that Nax is long lane. And so, yeah, we get our aggressive tri lane. Envy will go on a safe lane. That'll be what comes our way. So we'll just re-host up the game very, very quickly and get everybody back in again. Make sure I still got my, yeah, everything's still hosted, password's still the same. And there we go. Players start arriving. So we also realize too, we go AP mode. And get ourselves in. Let's get ourselves ready to rook and or rumble, and we should see Smugglik join into the game very, very quickly. He was the man which we are having this remake for. He was traveling home from his grandmother's place and wanted to play back at home where the internet's a hell of a lot better. So looking forward to that one. So we go with three more. Three more for in for the Radiant side. Because while we do have this time, remember, enter the competitions. They're over on joinDOTA.com or over on the Sapphire Technology Facebook page. All you got to do is make a comment. Win yourself some free stuff, guys. Win yourself some free stuff. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. And I cannot believe how long the Sindarin's taking. Come on, Sindarin. And Sindarin sends the image on the side saying, "Are you hosting? Are you hosting?" Yes. Yes, I have hosted. And we'll just check to see if our last is here. Oh wait, Sin just sent me messages on the side. Yeah, okay, there we go. Sin says an idiot. Okay, both ready? And let's get this party started. We've got Dota to play, peoples. We got Dota to play. So Sindarin's ready. Zizu. KP. 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 Beautiful. Wonderful. Love it. Go! Let's get this game underway. Let's get this game underway. See, there's always these little things that happen behind the scenes. Gotta make sure they all work out properly. But we are here in the game now. We are here in the game. Alright, so, in we launch. Of course, guys, if you do want to watch this through Dota TV, you can do so. You can do so. It's free inside of Dota TV. You'll need to search for one of these players' names on your screen, and then you'll have everything your heart desires as far as watching inside the game. And I'll say greetings to you from inside the game as well. We are streaming the audio out through Dota TV. So everything is there. And yeah. So players, select up the heroes. Of course, as I said, we were waiting for our last player, Smugglik, to join back into the game. And he has managed to arrive home. Stable connection, so we should have no delays. No delays. I cross my fingers and hope to live. Yeah, we'll have no delays getting ourselves into this game, or through this game, I should say. All right. So let's go. It's actually still counting down. Everyone selected their heroes, as you can see at the top of the screen. Everyone selected their heroes. But for some reason, always this happens on the captain's mode screen. It gets stuck. For no apparent reason, it always likes to get stuck. But in 2 seconds' time, we'll get ourselves in. And that 2 seconds is over. So there we go. All right. Game time. Run through our lineup. So Eternal Envy will be over here on the anti-mage. Pylai Dai as the Keeper of the Light. Bone 7 will be as the Nyx.
Prepare for
because
battle.
He plays a fantastic off-lane style hero. He is normally their off-lane player. But they're all running up north to start with Zizu as the Bane, and that leaves Arise as the final one as the Puck. Throwing over towards OTH, who are going to go and... I like these moves. I like these moves at the very, very start. They smoke up. They'll move themselves up. Oh, well done. Yeah, you already see the line that's been drawn. I instantly moved my screen to it, and the line's been drawn saying move up and try and get a gank. If they're feeling the KP are going to run an aggressive tri lane, but they want to protect their own woods to start with, the way you do that is by moving exactly the way KP are doing. In fact, Sindarin's already drawing the line. Yeah, he's saying they will go up this way. That's not Sindarin, is it? Yeah, it is. It's Sindarin. So he'll basically say... If he drew the line perfectly where KP is. This is a great prediction. So KP will walk this direction. They will check this region here, and then it's the movement back. It's the movement to come around this tree line because there's a big gap. There's a big fog of war right here where you're not going to see it. Or you move yourself up here, and then you get caught on this line. So OTH move into the ganking position, which is basically this box right here. Either that or they move, and they're going to go aggressive here. This is dangerous. This is more dangerous to do because you watch the vision here, and now Jakiro is spotted. That's the vision right there of the Dire side. So SD in first, he's looking for someone to disrupt, and he's way too far in. Disruption is there, Envy's gonna get caught, Connor Blast in all of the team. Shadow Demon is the first one to go down. Nice AoE stun by Syndra, but Eternal Envy's got a lot of space to do that damage, and Envy, if he gets away from this one, it's 0-0 for two. The trees are trying to attack him. His three heroes gonna go down. It's an absolute disaster right now for only Tidehunter. A quick sell by Smuggling will keep him alive. Envy getting blocked up a little bit there. He's not gonna blink. There's no mana for a blast. Smuggling's on the run. This should be a genocide. He's gonna deny himself to a creep wave which isn't spawned yet. So Pylite Die, wow, he's gonna really enjoy this solo experience on the kill. One more hit, one more hit. He's gonna get closer. The tower's gonna take it. But that's level two. That is such a huge thing as well. Not just the fact that all those kills happened and it was a 5-0 against OTH because they got aggressive. They got too overconfident when they moved just then. Jakiro got spotted here. And that allowed OTH, like they knew that KP was going to come, it allowed KP, yeah, you know, screw it. Envy stunned up and blinked away. So yeah, back to what I was saying. So we saw it. So KP could set a trap here. OTH moved directly into it. In fact, the SD went straight into it. He tried to disrupt for initiation once he was already initiated on. And that just destroyed it. And then Pylite Die gets a second level because he gets solo experience on the kill of the Nature's Prophet. So already there's Shaka Illuminate spam. They managed to find an opening. Syndra's already chaining off for the stun. Boar brings in a little bit of extra supplies and maybe a nightmare. Not going to go on Pylite Die. I thought Zizu would do that just to save him for a moment. But he went Brain Sap up at level 1, so there's no Nightmare option. He went for the nuke instead. Probably needed to live during that last engagement. That's at least a kill, so this is a nice aggressive try lane. The lane which I thought the KP was going to run is with the Nakes up here. So Nakes, Coddle as well as the Bane. That would have been a little bit easier to deal with this one. But Eternal Envy as the Animage, it's really nowhere near what they need to deal with this. This makes OTH's tri lane stronger. But they also lost 5 heroes at the very, very start of the game. So, you decide which one's a little bit better. Tri lane or entire genocide before game begins? Yep. And who really came out on top of that one? The gold per minute. Look at the gold per minute for Envy. He managed to pick up 1 kill, 1 death. Bane got 2 kills out of that. So, already walking around with his boots up. Might even see very early arcanes up here too, so it's gonna be never any mana. A quick D-Ward for the Radiant side, and now they can't see the Dark Ward unless they move themselves up a little bit further. But they want to get in there and D-Ward it. But to do so, they've got to come under the blast of the Illuminate, which is now only level 1 though. It's only a level 1 Illuminate. Put 2 points up into Chakra, so they can keep spamming out. Another blast gonna fly, disruptions there. Got a blast hits on the Jakiro, and Azizu is caught out. So quick Brain Sap, Nightmares available, Nature's Prophet's also going to TP in for this one. So now a tri-lane turns into a quad-lane, and they look for Pylite Die. And well done, Centaur. The entire OTH side gets stunned. As Envy's like, well, I want to keep farming, even though if there's like 4 heroes up here. If he's able to burn a little bit of mana off here of Smuggalik, might even just stop him from TPing back down to his lane, because he's missing from this bottom lane now. This is free farm for the Nakes, who's 12 for 4 up against 11 for 1. Nature's Prophet. In fact, Prophet's walking all the way back to base. How's the mid lane looking? We haven't even looked here. So Queen of Pain, normally one of the best laners in the game, but very easily countered by Puck's phase shift. So 16 for 8 for a rise. Up against this mid-solo Queen of Pain, who at this point is now 12 for 2 with that last scream, but taking a lot of damage to do it. And there's Nymphia's rune up the sleeve here of a rise. So once he pops level 6, look for a rotation. More sentry wards going down. There's an observer off on the side here. However, Envy takes all the mana of Syndra. Ice Pump is going to go, but there's just nothing to combo with it, so it would have to be Dual Breath instead. There's no mana consumables left up here to think. Look, even Jakiro. Leap Branch. This is what a leap branch is. A leap branch is when you've only got one ironwood branch. That's it. That's your only item. Everything else can be consumable, so you can actually hold consumables. But a leap branch build is literally one branch. It's called the leap branch. That's bottom man looking bone 7. Oh man, he's got a big creep wave with him right now. Moves in a range of the tower, so he's able to dive a little bit further. Then the open wounds. If he needs to, he's going to rage here. But Smuggly force TP out. Actually, he cancels the TP. Bone 7 is going to keep diving this one. He's got boots as well as that orb of venom, so Smuggling has to slow down, which means Bone 7 can catch up and just do this. Crew wave might take Smuggling right now. Not Ring a Ring of Rosie, and that's Nature's Prophet Death. Very, very simple. Looks like Cinderin's also in trouble up here in the top lane. One more attack, caught a blast. Oh, it almost picks off Shadow Demon. Jump and Envy. 1 second on the jump. The sounds are flying out. There's one hit already, and then blink away. Disjoints the attack on the tower. He'll need a salve or something. Because he didn't pick up the Ring of Regen. Yeah, there's a salve over here on the Bane. So he'll give it over to Envy. But 2-7. KP really controlling this game, even like straight from the start. Almost 3k worth of experience advantage, 2k worth of the gold. Most teams would normally just call a GG if they're going to lose all 5 heroes at the very, very start. But it looks like OTH have a little bit more confidence in their try lane. Chikiro, I'm wondering if Envy just fell asleep then for a moment. Of course, he is playing on Canadian time. So it's very early in the morning for him. Oh, nice blast down. And burns off the Mana of Esti, so there's no possible disruption here. That's the more important thing you're seeing coming up from KP. Envy's targets, which he's choosing, are very specific. He's mainly just looking... I mean, it's Bones haven't really doing this again. He's got phase boots. Smuggler can TP out from this one. Not enough damage. But his Prophet forced to retreat from the bottom lane again. Just cannot do anything down here. Just cannot do it. Arise. You know, it's gonna be a little bit more careful. Queen of Pain has enough mana for an ultimate, but Arise also knows that he's also got his own ultimate. Also got this wonderful thing called phase shift, so Queen of Pain's animations are very, very obvious what she wants to do. Really, did that SD just go down the top lane too? Yeah, keep it with a light blast. Level 2 on the Illuminate now. Nightmare was attempted. Not gonna happen. Goes out for Cinderin, and Cinderin's basically out of mana. Ice Path cuts it up, but Envy blink in 6 seconds time. Chikiro's off on the side, and Envy will hunt this one. Lifestealer did just pick up Thedas Prophet, and oh, did he just juke it? He juked it. Envy saw him. He came back down again, and now death. 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 Envy thought he was going to try and juke him again. He was 100% right. Kills everywhere.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And then the tier 1 tower will be brought down the top lane as well. I really thought this game was going to be closer, but that first move from OTH when they get caught out in the dire jungle. It's just one of those moments where we're like, yep, damn it to hell. And then Nakes is able to run a long... And like, long lane Nakes isn't a bad thing. In fact, it's actually quite a legitimate thing. But a long lane Nakes that it's got double the CS of a Nature's Prophet is a horrible thing. And there goes Pylai Dire. He is way too far out there. Sentry wards are down. Queen of Pain's using an Invis Root to try and initiate. Maternal Envy Aura has already realized what's going on. In fact, for some reason, he's also pulled an entire Radiant Creep Wave with him. There's the movement coming in. Envy, well, Bane's saying I want to initiate, but Queen of Pain can just hurl an ultimate and kill off Envy right now. And Envy's blinking away. Queen of Pain waited too long. Reveals herself. And there's a move out. At the same time, Arise now moving up. It's like, well, okay, if they're going to run through our jungle, we need to bring some help up here. And OTH doing the only thing they can do. Five-man Dota, force out mistakes here from KP and find some kills. They already got Pylai Dire. Cinder is chaining up the stun right now. Here in Queen of Pain, Alderman. It's not enough to get a kill. In fact, SD is the man to go down. Nightmare's up there as well. And Queen of Pain is able to pick off the Bane at the same time. Keeper of the Light, Blast will fly, and hello, Bone 7. Pylai Dire, he is chasing him everywhere across the map. Queen of Pain did get out, and Haystrun, who's going to get there? And it's Arise. Silence quickly, throws the orb. Not going to jaunt the back of that one. He's already got the movement speed. He runs down, and oh, what a prediction! What a prediction! That's going to be annoying as hell for Queen of Pain. Even the phase shift being used to avoid the Scream of Pain. Then another orb. Jaunt it down, going to get a range of this tower. Another rift, and he's going to get another. He's going to get a secondary kill. He's got bottle charges. Nice ice path. Maybe enough. Phase shift quickly. Got to bottle charge it up. And there it goes, plus the one charges. T1 tower take a fall, and another orb. Envy has found the Jakiro, and they're pinging even closer to go for the SD. He's only got 1 point in blink though. It's such a long cooldown time on that.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Alright, so it looks like again we're having ourselves some fun times with the live stream. Which is weird because I'm not getting any drops here. Very, very unusual. Just checked over on the side and I saw the live stream come down. So yeah, I don't know what the hell went on just then. Well, what happened actually 2 minutes ago, because you'll catch up to it then. It's the only downside. It's the reason why also you don't run like 6 minute delay on a live stream. Because if you do that, it'll take you 6 minutes to work out what's going wrong, and at which point you may have lost like half of the live stream. There we go, 4 to 14 now. 4 to 14. I'm trying to work out exactly what was lost there too. I'm guessing it was the top team fight, which you guys might have missed. The VOD will be completely fine, so if you want to, if you miss the details, actually no, I'm now checking it out. So you guys get to see the entire top team fight. It's fine. But like all things, guys, if the live stream ever screws up, we do all local recordings here and then upload them to youtube.com/joindota. So you can find all your details there. Whoa, Cinderin. Disruption. Tries to buy a little bit of time, but really, maybe even disrupting them. Cinderin then might have been a good option. But they get the kill on the bottom lane, KP. Just a very easy rotation. And Nakes is now building into an Orchid. He's looking to shut down that SD beyond all measure. Go first item is an Orchid, having a silence up your sleeve, and it's also gonna be for Estes disruption, but mainly probably for Queen of Pain. Queen of Pain is still that little jump kind of girl. Arias though is once he's got the blink dagger up and running, they won't have to worry about the Queen of Pain. That's what I was like, it's gotta be for like the a secondary hero, a support hero. And now, hello Estes. Nature's Prophet, TP's in, wants to go on the Bane, but that's going to hold him out of position. Queen of Pain jumped in with a double damage rune, and then TP. Nakes wants out of this one inside the Rage and will be successful. Call between four different heroes. And says, I don't want a part of it. Goes back to base, heals up. Bane through the Nightmare, also was not pursued. The Observer Ward from the Radiant side. It's seeing that ward a little bit further over, but it also shows you the fear that is there from OTH. They don't want to come up and deward this. They should see that. Yeah, the Observer Ward Sentry Ward. They most definitely see that Dire Sentry. So now Smorgalig will come up here and take care of it. I think he's still worried about that Bane. But that's why the trees are over on the side here. He knows exactly what's going on there. Syndra, however, has no idea what's going on here in the middle lane. Because he's being pincered. Envy's going to come in through the rear. They need a little bit of extra support, keeping the lights on the other side just spamming and hoping to do some damage. Level 3 Illumina up already, and Envy cuts the tree line. Ping's coming up, he knows exactly where Cinderin is, so blink in. Cinderin goes into Chemical Rage, and couldn't have come at a better time for him. Envy's gonna burn a lot of his mana, and blinks down. Oh, he couldn't get the path, because the phase boots, and allowed him to come through, and then Zoi. Now all he wanted to do was help. Cinderin will get stunned up right now. He throws out his own stun, looking for an AoE, gets on Envy as well as on the Bane. The brain saps. And the Quap ulti hitting very, very hard there on KP. But it's just not enough. Moving themselves back, and now they want to make a play. Look at Jakiro. He wants the best ice path of his life. The rage is there. It stops Pylite die. Already, though, the Nakes managed to get himself out this one. And Envy wants to stick around. Queen of Pain's on very, very low life. Pylite die. He wants to bring some help back to him. That hit is going to hit from the Alchemist, and he does. Bone 7 actually TP back, healed up a little bit. Disruptors, they're pulling him out. Pylite will go down. Shadow Demon takes his life. He had enough poison stacks on him to kill him off. The Eternal Envy is just running up this SD. This is just higgledy-piggledy. I need a Benny Hill theme to be playing right now. Because it is in three different locations this fight. Takiro dies further up. Meanwhile, a little bit further down here. Blink up. Nice rift. Really nice rift. And then a triple kill for Arise. Queen of Pain is the only one to escape from this one. This fight went that direction. It went that direction. It went up that way. And then it also went up this direction. Everybody went two ways to whatnot. And it goes 5 to 21. Only way to win this going 1-on-1. Well, KP enjoyed that. They've already got the higher levels and the higher farm. So 1-on-1 engagements are exactly what he wants to have. And now the tier 1 tower to be harassed and try and be brought down in the mid. But not going to happen just yet. I say just yet. As Bane comes in with now level 6, so he's now got Fiend's Grip. Oh, Prophet, you may not want to do this Nightmare. Just quickly. Didn't go for the Sprout, so Scream, Sting. If he needs to, a Brain Sap's still there. I think he's considering it right now. Yep, there goes the brain sap. Prophet Ottoman also bouncing through, but his life just comes straight back. There's three levels of brain sap. Goes up, Nightmare off cooldown. 2 seconds time. Support should be able to get here by now. There's four heroes chasing a Bane. While Envy continues to farm on the bottom lane, now being 1,200 away from having, or actually even that, 1,150 away from having his Battle Fury up and running. 14 minutes in with so many fights going on. It's 5 for 21. Experience advantage in 14 minutes. It's almost 1,000 a minute right now as far as experience goes. Gold sitting about 10k. And Pilot Eyes bringing friends. Is that bottom lane? Yep, it's Envy. Envy up to the top lane. It's like, hey, sweet. What's up, Smuggler? You wanna play? You wanna play? It's never too late to play. You can never be too old to play. Especially when Keeper does that kind of thing. Oh, blink down. He's just holding the creep wave here. That's all that was for, and now he's in too deep. But long timing on, like, low cooldown on the blink now because he's up to level 4. So the Ice Path couldn't get there in time. Cast animation for Ice Path is just so damn long. And Envy again. So he's trying to bait them with this blink to initiate on him and keep their attention up here. And it's working, too. Bane, Nakes, as well as Puck here in the middle lane. Puck looking for a blink into ulti. And there's two supports who are begging for it. Nice phase shift. Still going to get hit by the Ice Path because it remains. But Nakes destroys the life points of the SD. The Macro Pyre is down. And now Queen of Pain also in the mix here. SD's walking around such low life. Four heroes together. Bone 7 will take him. Probably bounces through. He's got an Infest but needs a creep to do it with. Wilkins around the side, Keeper the Light Blast comes out. Now he's like, well, open wounds off cooldown in a moment. Cinderant, let me leech your life. Please, 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 please. Puck will throw the ult. Is it Wilkins even here? It came in for the Nakes if he wants it, but he doesn't need it. They just take their lives the old-fashioned way. Stand, seal, and deliver. SD's back, but only because he died far, and he's such a low level. That's 5 to 26 now on the board. And that Lord to push the tier 2 tower now in the mid. I was talking about KP having a lot of success of late. It seems like it's not really changing for him. We'll see how they go though when the rest of the joint are open. Of course, there's a rough competition here. The best of the best of the best. KP able to get themselves the grand final of the Masters and then signed up for the Open. Of course, during the Masters, they were basically schooled. Like, they were really schooled by Na'Vi. It was 2-0 from that one, but they also managed to also obliterate EG. Like, EG really didn't know what hit them in that game. Envy, blink away, Ice Path, nice little combo, Envy said. Even the quality, that is some hatred. That is some serious hatred. The Alchemist stun should have been enough just there, and now they also found Smuggler. A little bit further down, so it becomes a one-for-one trade, but the Animage is obviously a lot better to bring down. I mean, even better if they managed to kill off the Courier. It's walking around with a mech. Not a full one, just the recipe for it. And that'll be for Keeper of the Light. He's already got the other parts of it. Queen of Pain trying to make the most out of this one, trying to force out the tier 1 tower in the mid. Nice little ancient stack over on the side there. Animage will enjoy that later on. 1k gold up now for Alchemist. How's he actually keeping up with the net worth? An Alchemist with Grievel's Greed, or basically what is Goblin's Greed, sitting at 3.2k. Four heroes from KP are higher than him, and Bane is almost the same. Shows you how much has been shut down, and now Orchid's up. Queen of Pain gonna try and blink out of this one, but the damage is just too fast, too hard. Short-lived creatures. And that welcomes in the Orchid. And they go to the tier 2 tower now. Buy back by the Queen of Pain. So that's right, it looks like she didn't have money to spare. Prophet Ottoman trying to slow this one down, and Bone 7 doesn't want to take that damage. He just pops into Rage, tanks it up, and there goes Tao. Nice denial. Oh no! Actually thought that was really nicely done by the Queen of Pain. But it wasn't. Puck takes the last hit. Smuggling trying to push out that top lane, extra TP's coming in. Arise just blinks, there's Nakes in here. Blinks away, throws out the Ottoman, Smuggling. Tries to TP out. Cinderine's a very good stun right now, but not going to happen. Wonderful phase shift from Arise. He evades the damage, and Cinderine, there should be enough, and there is enough. Damage before the TP is able to complete. Nakes walking around. Didn't even have to use the Orchid. How was even that Puck walking around? Blink. It's just intelligence trades as well as null talisman. He's got 3k gold. We're looking at another scythe of ice coming. Why did I just feel like I was Scottish? Wow, that wasn't even intentional. It's rather amusing considering I actually have Scottish heritage. If you didn't notice because of the red hair. Alright, can't be bottom lane now. Two remaining out of towers. I'll see if they can bring it in. Courier brings supplies. Full mech, gem. Mech's already on the Keeper of the Light. The gem is dropped off. If there's even a thought about a Shadow Blade from Alchemist, it now should go out the window. Which he is, he's got a claymore on him. It stops that. And there goes the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. Everything was fizzling a little bit in the acid spray, but is that like level 1? Yeah, it's level 1 acid spray. That's doing very minimal damage or effect. And Envy in the meantime is just taking care of all of the Radiant creeps inside their jungle. There's just so much money for him. Even trying to deward up on the high ground, but nothing's there. Just a sentry ward from the Radiant side. They need a gem. Someone's going to walk closer with a gem. Not going to happen. Envy wants to stare down the bottom lane. 2,300 gold up his sleeve now. 2,400 in the nakes. And now Infest. So they're going to use that. Wow, really? Jump up. Cinder is out way too far. The Orchid's on him. It just rages to walk through the ice path and then starts beating down the Jakiro. Same time, Cinder in too much damage. Blink in AM ultimate. Bane takes the kill, though. He got the brain sap off in time. And now Envy, a little bit too far in, but then at the same time, Fiend's Grip is up here on the Queen of Pain. And now one last hit. There it is. In fact, it was the creep wave that ended up killing off Queen of Pain. 3 euros on the sidelines, 20 minutes in. They assault through the bottom. Fortification will come off from the Radiant side. And Ryze will be brought in by Keeper of the Light in a moment once he gets back to base and heals up a little bit more. Pop that ultimate and drag in his teammates. Blink Dagger also now perched up on the Bane. Wondering if they're gonna... No. See, they've got a Ryze here. Just put on a Ryze. Bring him in. It's fine. Oh, no. Ryze put a level 2 Dagon. Okay. Maybe it'll be Roshan, then they'll go. Because he's up and running. And anyways, just spent some cash as well. So what's on this courier? Vladimir's offering for anyways. Yeah, this is Roshan. I'll have the extra lifesteal, and that also stacks up as well with what Nakes gives to himself. And he also finds a regeneration rune to boot. And he's like, can I take that? Can I take... It's like Bone 7. Right, he got scattered for a moment there. The pings are coming out to initiate. Keeper of the Light, there's the Orchid of the SD. No disruption, he's dead. He's going to pop from this Orchid even if he doesn't get the hit last time. And they find Cinderin. Oh, it's just so brutal. It's like watching Bloodsport and you see the bone come out of the side of the leg and you're just like, it's horrible. There's a classic moment in movies and you just can't not look. It's also quite gross. I kind of feel like physically sick every time I see that movie. And they go, look for the opening. Open wounds and Orchid again. Shadow Demon cannot do anything against that. In fact, there is nothing right now that OTH can do. Maybe they can kill off Arise. Arise! Oh, he missed time the phase shift. Travels faster. He got killed by the Queen of Pain. Nakes with a quick infest, and Puck will just buy back. Where's Keeper of Light? Ultimate, bring him in. Maybe not. He wants to kill off top lane first. Lick! Bouncing around with the... why am I dying? Oi! Oi. So Envy's gonna solo up Roshan. Okay. He'll drop the Quelling Blade. The hell, he's jumping out of here? Come on, Envy. Oh, sorry. There's farm to be had. There's black dragons that must die. That's what he'll get. And meanwhile, back at Roshan. It's not as though he's going anywhere. And Envy comes back with full life points because the black dragons didn't do enough damage to him. 4k gold. Yasha. Sanjay Yasha comes away of Nakes. He could take these guys and have it. If he wanted to. Sells the stick and buys it instead. Didn't have to sell the stick, man. Roshan's finally gone down. Eternal Envy will take it. And there's an extra 200 gold for him anyway. Walk past the Enter Stag. It's like, do I take gold or do I not take gold? Question is very, very difficult of life. There you go, Rise. Back to base. Level 3 day gone now. Keeper of the Light finally uses his ultimate recall.
Invisibility.
How far ahead are they? About 30k. And there goes the warning of OTH. But they're going to try and put on a show at least. All they got to do is destroy that Puck, because Puck at this point is insulting them. And they see Puck move in, but at the same time, KP have had this ward inside the base of OTH for a very, very long time. They know exactly what's going on in here. They know exactly when they move out, just like I can see on the bottom lane where Nature's Prophet's about to die. Any mage will initiate, and then boom, 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 and blink, blink, blink in, AM ultimate, cancel the TP out. And Keeper of the Light, ulti still on cooldown. So a quick pause by Arise. Needs a moment. Needs a moment, then they're good to go. As far as the rest of the open goes, by the way, guys, looks like 4FC. 4FC managed to bring down Brazil. I see Kaipi playing up against Winra right now. KP will advance themselves through to the next round, judging by what is happening with this game. It's 7 for 38, and they have an advantage of 25,000 gold and over 30k experience. So if they lose this game, then it's beyond Game of Throws. Like, this will be the ultimate mocking. Like, there was some jokes made about the six-slotted anti-mage of Loda and the way that he died with that one, but there's also going to be a huge amount of mocking if you can lose from this far advantage. Dagon going to be used completely unnecessary, but at this game, everything is necessary. And then there's too many anti-mages. Alchemist will stun up himself, and that is it. This will be mid racks, be bottom racks, and GG, well played. That is what goes the way of KP. So KP go into the semi-finals, and a one game away, they'll face up against either Arctic or TO. TO, the team, the from Romania, who was able to bring down the QPAD Red Pandas. But it's looking really, really good right now for KP. To get themselves into not only the final for the Open, but also the final which they already had for the Masters. I'm interested to see though if it'll be a Russian team that goes up against him, or will it be a Swedish team? 4FC is sitting there. They're feeling pretty good. They brought down Fnatic EU, 4FC. Sometimes a little bit unsung heroes as far as the team goes. They're a high quality team. That'll be the next game we do. So 4FC versus up against, it was Winra that brought down HWA. So, yeah, go Cinderin. There's a gem there. He stuns himself in, fizz around everybody. But yeah, so I see Kaipi playing up against Winra right now. Knowing Russian Dota, it shouldn't take too long. Either a win or a lose, either way, it's gonna complete. And that means that'll be our second semi-final. We'll cast the lower bracket semi-final. And then jump ourselves into the grand final. They're the last two games for tonight. Best of one for the semi-finals. And then the best of three grand final. And we'll see how the cookie doth crumble. That'll be happening in a moment. So stay tuned on the live stream. We shall be returning here in a couple of moments' time with more Dota 2 action for your viewing pleasure. And as always, guys, make sure you check out your details and where you can win some stuff. And if you're looking for a new copy of the Bioshock Infinite, then head yourself over to joinDOTA.com. Comment on the articles that say comment and win. And also, you can win also some wonderful graphics cards. So it's from Sapphire, the Radeon HD 7790. You can win it from either there, or head yourself over to the Facebook page. It's facebook.com/Sapphire Technology. And make a post, a comment. And the thing you're looking for is this big banner here. Make a comment there. There's already a lot of people who are entering. But considering your chance of winning a graphics card out of that one, when there's like 400 people that signed up for it, you got some pretty good odds, people. You got some pretty damn good odds right there. And of course, that's thanking everybody up there who went to the Facebook page yesterday during the broadcast, and basically also said thank you for supporting Dota 2. So that's because of you guys that they're giving away a brand new card. Hope you enjoy it, and hope you'll enjoy the next semi-final. We'll be back here in a moment. 4FC, who will they be facing up against? You'll find out shortly.